So today's lecture will quickly have a recap of what has happened in the last class. So in the last class, we have seen what are the different stages in transportation planning process. Then how do you evaluate between choices? Then how is alternative been implemented? Then what are the challenges in any transportation planning process? So after this, you have seen what travel demand and what travel supply is. And then what is four-stage travel demand model? So today's class is an interesting topic. We will be seeing what mass rapid system is or what mass rapid transport system is. So here, looking at this picture or looking at this photograph, what inference can you come up to? So here you can see 360 people. Here you have 300 car, or instead of 300 car, you have six buses or you have one metro. Okay, so it clearly shows how the traffic congestion can be reduced by providing what? By providing public transport or mass transport, right? To solve the traffic congestion problem, it's always better to encourage, okay, it's always better to encourage public transport or mass transport system. So can anyone comment on this photograph you have? You can see the clock here from 12 a.m. to 3 a.m., 3 a.m. to 6 a.m., 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. So what is the speed that any vehicle can attain? So between 12 a.m. to 3 a.m., the speed that the vehicle can attain is 31 kilometer per hour. So if you look at 9 a.m. to 12 p.m., it is 19 kilometer per hour. So what does this shows? What does this imply? So this is actually the speed status in India that was recorded in 2017. So what does this imply? What does this picture imply?
It shows traffic condition, which
Yeah, it
slow down
actually
some.
shows, yeah, it slows down what? It slows down the speed of the vehicle, right? So you can see the fastest is between 12 a.m. to 9 a.m. So the moment office hours or the education institution time starts, what happens? The speed considerably reduce. So this the lowest you have between what? From 9 or from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. Right? So in that 12-hour clock, the slowest happens. So it's typically especially from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. So this again, what does this first two photographs show? Can anyone say what does those two photographs show?
Separate lanes for buses.
Yeah, you can
But
see
traffic.
separate, yeah, bus track, or you can see busways. Okay, separate lanes for buses. So have anyone seen separate bus lanes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
Ma'am,
ma'am.
even in Bangalore, they started, ma'am.
Yeah, in Bangalore it has been started. So what is the use of providing separate bus lane?
Ma'am, since buses are the heavy vehicles,
Okay, yeah.
it's very hard to move them. Like if you want to switch lanes and all, so if the bus is going in the rightmost lane and it has to stop on a stop, it has to come back to the leftmost lane.
Yeah,
So it's
yes.
just a lot of traffic. So instead of that, a bus lane is provided that stick to stick to that only.
Yeah, that's a good point. So what might be the feeling of the people those who are over this side of the road or over this side of the road? Or since all the buses are going towards this side, what might be the people in these vehicles might be thinking? Obviously, there might be an
They'll
ears.
think even we should
Yeah.
start going in public transport. Yeah,
Yeah,
yes. So they
people
might be thinking,
use
yeah.
public vehicles,
Yeah,
dump their
because
car
they
towards the
will,
lane.
yeah, they might be feeling that they need a separate lane, or they might be feeling that, rather than honking in this, or rather than, wasting their energy in this side, they can comfortably sit in this side, right? So that might be the thought that might be there among these people. Now, what about this? What about this photograph denote? Can anyone comment? So let us assume that the number of people in all these photographs are same. The same length of the road, it's the same road. So here you can see how many number of people can be accommodated in a bus. The same how many bicycles might be required, and for the same, I think not even same, might be half of the people can be accommodated, can be only accommodated in these many number of cars, right? So the best alternate to reduce congestion is, having proper public transport system. So let's see in detail. So here again, this is the greenhouse emissions from different forms of transport. So here you have bike or walking at zero. Then you have, you know, public transport, you have 0.003. Then, so this is in kilograms of greenhouse gas per person per kilometer. Okay. So let's assume that one person here. So here, this is again one person. So for this, if you're taking four people in this car, it is 0.042. So this is for a fuel efficient car. Now for an average car, for a large four-wheel driving, then for fuel efficient car, again, for this driver only for the driver, see, it is 0.17. Whereas when you have four people, it is 0.042. So you can see the comparison here, right? So in these three options, you have four people are at least occupying the car. But in the other three, though it is fuel efficient car, but only with the driver, the fuel emission, the greenhouse gas emission is 0.17. Again, for an average car, it is 0.32. For a large four-wheel drive car, it is 0.44 for only the driver. Right. So that is again causing what? That is again increasing the greenhouse emissions. Right. So now again, by mode of transport, you can see. So it's average emissions per kilometer per person. So for a train, it is 3 to 21 gram of carbon dioxide per kilometer. Sorry for the delay. So here, again, you can see a light rail. So it is 4 to 22 gram carbon dioxide per kilometer. So you can see for electric vehicle, it is really less, provided it is powered by renewable energy per person. But for an average car, it is 250 grams of carbon dioxide per kilometer, right? So the comparison, you can see how the transport emissions are varying, or average emissions per kilometer is varying as the mode of transport is changing, right? So now what is this mass transit system? So this is any form of public transportation, a shared transportation that can commute a large number of people at the same time. Okay. So it the passengers are transported from origin to destination. It can be based on a no reserved basis or on a reserved basis. So its mass transit system can also be termed as public transport system. So the public transport system can be fixed route system or non-fixed route system. Can you give an example for fixed route system? Where the routes are fixed.
Metros, ma'am.
Yeah, metros are fixed route system.
Even then, buses.
Yeah,
buses. BMTC buses.
Yeah, BMTC buses. Yeah. Then what about non-fixed route system?
Taxi, ma'am.
Taxi, yes, then.
Uber, Ola.
Uber, Ola, yes. Right, then.
Bicycle.
That again, Uber, Ola can be when you are, you know, on a share basis, you can say it as a public transport, right? Or, you know, you can say it as a public shared transportation. Then bicycle, but that's not again a public shared transportation system.
Yes.
It should be able to commute a large number of people at the same time from origin to destination. Then when you have contract carriages, like when you have buses, you know, for trips, right? So that is again transporting, you know, large number of people, but it's not a fixed route system, right? It changes, you know, on different days of the time or on different days on the week, the route will be changing. Then the advantages are it's economical, eco-friendly, and the time consumption is less. So provided we have different clauses, how the time consumed can be less. Okay, so the two main public transport system that you might have heard about is rail and bus. So rail, again, you have heavy rail, light rail, metro or subway, and commuter rail. In bus, again, you have bus rapid transit systems and buses moving in mixed traffic. So you know that in Bangalore also, rapid transit system, wherein bus will be moving in a separate lane. That is about rapid transit systems. Okay, buses moving in mixed traffic means in the same traffic, buses will also be having moment. So we will see in detail about all these differences. Yeah, so we have busways and bus rapid transit system. Then we have light rail transit. So that means in this, the mass transit system is rail based, but it's in the same grade. That means there's no grade difference. Okay, so these are light rail transit system. So tramways, where have you seen tramways?
Not in India, but in foreign.
Yeah, these are again at grade. Yeah, Kolkata. These are again
even in India, it's there, ma'am.
Yeah, in Kolkata. Yeah, so this is again at grade rail system, but there is they move in the mixed traffic conditions itself. Okay, so light rail transit system are usually, you know, the in Bombay you have. Okay, you have the train system over there is more reliable transportation system. Okay, so that is again at the same grade, but it has been segregated from the main carriageway. Okay, tramways are again at the grade rail system. At the grade means same level, but they're not segregated. And they usually will be moving in the same, in the mixed traffic conditions. Then metro rail. Metro rail is completely segregated from main rail system, right? Is the metro rail running in the same main rail system? No, it's a fully segregated rail system. It can be in the, it can be at the grade, it can be elevated, or it can be underground. At the grade, you usually say that when it is in the same level with the traffic system. Okay, so it can be at the grade, elevated, and underground. I hope you might have traveled across all the three metro rail system, right? At grade, elevated, and underground. And it can have a capacity of 40,000 to 80,000. So PPHPD is the term that is used to denote the capacity. So PPHD means passengers per hour per direction. So passengers in an hour in along any one direction. Okay, so 40,000 to 80,000 passengers will be traveling in 1 hour along one direction. So it can also include monorails. So monorails are having lower capacity, but the infrastructure space that it will consume is comparatively less. Then you have regional rail, right? A regional rail will be connecting cities to the other cities, to outskirts of the center of the city. So the basic requirement of any mass rapid or any mass transit system is, it should be able to transport people at an affordable cost and with some reasonable rate of return. Right, when it has to operate, you might have seen in the metro rail, right? So the infrastructure cost that has to come, the other miscellaneous charges that will be coming. So whatever, the cost that has to be returned, that should be justifying the operation of that transportation system. So usually, a mass rapid system should integrate car, bicycles, and walking. So that means, the transportation system that has been implemented should be should be integrated with the car, bicycle, and pedestrians as well. So, and they obviously contribute, a better image of the city. So these are the latest technologies in mass transit system. You might have heard about Hyperloop. Have you heard about Hyperloop? At least you might have seen beautiful videos on Hyperloop, right? So you find an evacuated tube and a series of pod will be moving. So the speed the Hyperloop promises is about 750 miles per hour. Okay. So here, inside the evacuated tube, what happens is the wind resistance will be comparatively less, right? In usual monorail or in metro rail, what happens is the speed gets reduced because of the wind resistance. The direction of the wind and the direction of the movement of the vehicle will be in the opposite direction. So you'll be having the wind resistance coming into picture wherein it reduces speed. But in Hyperloop, this evacuated tube promises what? Reduce wind resistance and assures the speed of 750 miles per hour. Pod taxi system. Anyone seen pod taxi system? Anyone? So in this you have, let me see. Yeah. So this is a typical photograph showing a pod. It replaces a car and you can have 5 to 6 passengers. Okay, it will be on an elevated rail And then you have electric or hybrid vehicles. So that is the new, the promising technology in vehicle transportation. But again, the points, the you require better infrastructure when you have to provide electric or hybrid vehicle. What are the infrastructure that you might require when you have more electric or hybrid vehicles in a city?
Recharging stations.
Yeah, that is, yeah, good. That is the challenge for electric or hybrid vehicles, right? You should be having recharging stations, because it's not like any other vehicle, you know, in case if you're, you know, driving in your two-wheeler or in your four-wheeler. What happens if suddenly fuel get exhausted? You, at the worst, you can, you know, have a bottle with you. You can, you know, get the necessary fuel or, yeah, necessary fuel from the nearby station. But electric vehicle, you cannot go in that kind of a fashion. So there should be the distance between each electric charging station should be comparatively less, right? So that is quite a challenge for having electrical hybrid vehicle in our country. So this is a photograph. This is actually a graphic image showing Hyperloop, because it's still in testing phase. It's still not commercialized. So here you have, these are pods. Okay. So these are some of the typical pictures showing how the public transport has been arranged. So here you can see a triple road system. So here this red lane is typically bus lane, and blue and green are the local road system. Okay. So here again, you can see a bus stand, and here you have access for disabled as well. Okay. Then here again, you can see a metro leaving a suburban station. And here the advantage over here is you can see bus stop also just below this suburban station. That is actually a good advantage of the suburban station. So that's the main challenge that's been faced in Bangalore Metro. The connectivity or the interchange from one service to another service is comparatively less here. Okay, so now these two photographs show the exclusive lane for bus transit. Then here again, you have, you know, the measures that have been in place for fast entry and exit for the passengers. Then here again, you can see separate lane. So this is again a separate cycle lanes, right? Many of us, you know, are still scared to take cycle in the usual traffic, mainly because of what, there are no exclusive cycle lanes, right? If there are exclusive cycle lanes, you can be safe while moving in the vehicular traffic, right? That is one of the disadvantages that is lacking in our country. So now you can see a quick comparison between the metro rail system and bus rapid transit system. So this is the commercial speed that will be there for bus transit and for metro rail. Then the catchment area that has been, catchment area, you have any idea what catchment area will be if you have studied in fluid mechanics or
water,
in hydrology?
Rainwater.
Yeah, that is in terms of hydrology, but what might be catchment area over here?
The area it covers, ma'am.
Yeah, very good. The area that it can cover. So for catchment area for a reservoir is nothing but how much area it can, you know, it can actually provide water to. So here this catchment area will be how much area it can cover, right? How much area for transportation it can provide. So here the catchment area for metro rail system will be low. Why? The infrastructure that is required for metro rail is quite huge, right? It's quite complicated compared to bus rapid system. So that is why the catchment area for metro system is comparatively less. Then the average cost per trip is also comparatively high for metro rail system. Then the minimum trip length is 10 to 15 kilometers. You cannot just travel for 2 kilometers in a metro rail. Can you do that? No. Minimum that can be covered is 10 to 15. Then you can see what's the space required. Then the parking. Okay, so it needs parking for the feeder services. So here also it needs parking facilities. So then noise pollution reduction. So noise level may slightly increase, but here no significant improvement in ambient noise levels. the environmental condition, you can see what might be the noise and vibration level over here. Then road safety. Okay, so it reduces accidents by because metro rail are not usually in the mixed traffic system, right? It will be having its own or a dedicated rail system. It can be at the grade, it can be underground, or it can be elevated. So here, bus rapid is less safe for pedestrians and for non-motorized transportation. Then it reduces congestion to some extent. So here, it can reduce the congestion provided other transit systems are comparatively less. So the cost of infrastructure is comparatively high for metro rail system, whereas here you probably require a bus stand and then bus waiting shelters. So this is the passenger carrying capacity. So here the passenger carrying capacity is more for metro rail, whereas in bus rapid transit system, it is less. Then the vulnerability to natural and man-made disaster will be high for metro rail and it will be comparatively less for bus rapid. Then the passenger fare, which will be economical when you have to travel more than 10 kilometers, right? But for bus travel, it is comparatively economical for 3 to 5 kilometers. But more the distance that you may have to cover, it can be compared. The rate is almost comparable with metro rail system. Okay, so these are the main difference between metro rail and bus rapid transit system. So a bus rapid transit system usually involves what you have segregated lanes. It can be at the grade or it can be elevated. So here you can see typical lane for bus alone. Okay, and then modernized bus technology will be provided. That means automatic movement of the passengers, then the more advanced features in the bus waiting shelters. So these technologies will be provided. Then in BRTS, it usually include, or this modern technology usually include, the rapid boarding and alighting. That means getting out of the bus. Then efficient fare collection system. Then comfortable shelters and stations. Then clean bus technologies. Then modal integration. Modal means different modes of transportation. Okay, it has to be integrated. Then sophisticated marketing identity. And then excellence in customer service. So the advantages, I think we have listed the difference between rapid system and light rail transit system. So from this itself, we can conclude the advantages of both of them. So it is highly flexible, requires special facilities, and several routes can converge into one, then lower capital costs, lower operating costs, then it can be used by more people, it can serve larger geographical area, and it can also work in phases. But a light rail transit system or a metro rail, whenever you have a picture of light rail, it's easy for you to remember the metro transit system. So the demand is more, comfort is more, capacity is more, operating cost is less, but has a more positive land use impact. Then whenever you have metro station coming up, you find that the property values are increasing, or you see new apartments being coming up, right? So it represents or shows that the property values are increasing. Then less air and noise pollution, then higher ridership, that means more people can commute at the same time. Then rail stations are usually being more pleasant compared to bus stations. Then greater travel speed. Then it improves the community image, and it also provides superior service quality. So the limitations are, again, buses are having poor public image, then the quality service is quite poor, then flexibility and decentralization is still not on a positive side, and bus rapid system is always a temporary solution. So long rail system, the initial cost is high, infrastructure cost is high, then the benefit is skewed. That means it's not bias. So you have and also it's been observed that the longer the trips, you will be having more stops. Okay, so these are some of the limitations of both the systems. So this we have again seen. So now what might be the disadvantages of any mass communication system, mass or public transportation system? So here we have compared between two systems, bus system and the train system. So what might be the advantages we have seen? So first, let's see what are the advantages of mass transit system. What are the typical advantages of any mass transit system? Anyone?
Reduces pollution.
Yeah, I want someone else to answer. Yaksha, good. Reduces pollution. That means it has some good environmental impact, right? It reduces pollution. Then anyone else?
Ma'am, as we do not drive, we can sit there and relax, ma'am.
Yeah, you can relax. So it can save some time, right? Maybe you can spend time in reading, or you can spend time in watching some videos, or you can some time in learning. So actually it saves time. Then good. Then anyone else? So you have
reduction in accidents.
Yeah, accident. So it means that congestion has been reduced, so eventually accidents are also been reduced. Okay, good, Gaurav. Then that's all. I hope all of you have traveled in both train as well as in your own car to the same destination. Then?
Ma'am, it is economical.
It's economical, right? It's, you have a good economic impact. Then? That's all.
Stress relief, ma'am.
Yeah, good. It's a stress relief. Then?
Comfortable for the long distance.
Yeah, it is comfortable then.
Social integrity is increased.
Yeah, social integrity. How can social integrity be increased? Yes, we all have seen, we all have felt that, but how can it be increased? Anyone wants to help Aishwarya with that point? How can social integrity be increased? Social integrity, what do you mean by? Yeah.
Ma'am, like every day when we commute in the bus, there'll be certain people who travel every day in the same route. So we might, get friends with them. So maybe that is what Aishwarya is trying to tell.
Yeah.
Socially, talk.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. You meet different people. You meet different people from different community, right? So that actually, have a good impact on our integrity. Then, good point. Then, anything else?
Hello.
Yeah. Yes, Aishwarya.
Ma'am, I'm sorry, it got cut.
No problem.
Cost effective.
I think Chandana has filled in some points there. Cost effective. Yes, it is cost effective. Then. Yes, Narmada, then. That's all. I'm waiting for some more.
Energy efficient, ma'am.
It is energy efficient, yes, then. Good.
The impacts of environment will be reduced.
Yeah, impact on environment will be reduced, right, then. Some more point. I think I only the one who has felt that? I don't know. So let me see who has that kind of an impact also. So you can just imagine when you were, 15 or 14 years old and now. What?
Time.
I don't know what. Yeah?
Time.
Time, yeah. You have saved time. Yes, then.
It's safer, ma'am.
Yeah, it is safer then. Yeah, there is, again, aspects of safety also we have when we look into the limitations. But yeah, it's safe. Then,
ma'am, we can expect more number of buses and more number of trains at the same time.
Yeah, yeah, okay. But now we are looking into the limitations of any transit system, any public transport transit system. That is a good, a valid point between the comparison between bus and a light rail. But what might be the impact or advantages of any public transport system?
Ma'am,
lesser traffic violations.
Yes, Abhishek?
I think lesser traffic violations because some people, they tend to ride faster. And if those people start using public transport, maybe the traffic violations will come down.
Yes, compared to lesser traffic violations. Yes, then Chandana, you were having some point there.
No.
Yeah, then anyone else?
Universal design.
Yes.
universal design.
It's universal design. What do you mean by that point?
How is it an means impact? That yeah. Manufacturing mass number of vehicles, a similar yeah. type of vehicles.
Good. Yes, yes, yes. So, you know, you don't need so many, you know, competitions among who is having this brand of a car. And the design is also uniform. So the cost that can come into manufacturing is also reduced. Good. Excellent. Good point. Then. One more point that you can include is not everyone will be in a position to drive, right? They will not be having the capacity to drive. So for them also, it's a very good impact of having, sorry, it's advantages that about a good public transport system is in place. Okay, so that is also one of the advantages of having a public transport system in place. So now what might be the limitation? Yeah.
Technological development in particular area or a particular yeah. city.
Yes, yes. The area will be
based on developed. Mode of transports.
And yeah, good. How whenever people you, that's what. Yeah, whenever you find metro trail being developed, you find, you know, right, the property price gets increased, more you know, shops and more commercial spaces comes up, right? Okay, so those are the advantages. Now, what will be the limitations for any public transport system? Any limitations for public transport system?
Ma'am, if you take the example of COVID now, the contracting the infection will be higher, ma'am.
Yeah, yes, that is a good point. So now we are, you know, quite skeptic in traveling in any public transport system, right? It's true. Then,
ma'am, depends on the peak hour as well. If in a particular peak hour there'll be too many people, in some other time there'll be two people, so that. Yeah, the economy will not be so equally distributed in two times.
Yes, yes. Then any other limitations?
Ma'am, in public transport, we have to follow the standard route, ma'am. But we cannot go wherever we wish. So in private yes. Transport, we can go wherever we wish.
Yeah, so that problem can be solved when you have proper connectivity, right? So just if you are boarding a metro, at the metro station, you should be having either a proper cab facility or you should be having the next bus facility. So if that connectivity is there, then that issue can also be solved. So if you look at any metro case study, most of the metros, this connectivity is actually a problem. Good, good point. Then
it doesn't run according to our timings, ma'am.
Right, good. Yeah, it doesn't, we may end up, you know, wasting our time sometimes, most of the time. Then?
Ma'am, if something happens to one transport, then people who are sitting there, all will be affected by that.
Yeah, correct. That's also a limitation. Good. Then? Limitation. I think all of you would have traveled in public transport systems. So what are the other limitations?
Ma'am, thefting or robbery, like that things can.
Yeah, excellent, excellent. Yeah, you know, there are chances of the concern of safety, right? There's concern of your own safety in public transport system. Good. Then.
Okay, so I think. Privacy, like,
yeah, yes.
If you want to study, an important call.
Yeah, so this, yes, the safety concern is there. Then whenever any accident may happen, the amount of the number of casualties will be more, right? So I think we have covered all these points by each one of you. Each one of you have presented, yeah. I think we have covered all the points, right? The setup is the infrastructure for any transport.
Hygienic.
So people can be attacked by infectious disease, and then late night safety is not assured, then accident can cause large casualties, then sudden change in time of certain buses will be inconvenient, then you know, if there is any malfunctioning of equipment, there can be, you know, service disruption. So these points of I think most of us we have discussed, these are the limitations of any public transport system. Okay, so with this, I have discussed almost all the important points of mass rapid transit system. So in today's class, I have shared a question. I hope all of you have got that in your newsfeed. So the question is typically, how can public transport system reduce the congestion? So I hope all of you have seen the question. So how can a bus rapid transit system decongest roads? So this was a question I have posted in the group. I want individually all of you to answer. Okay, so the answer, your valid answer carries some weightage for your assignment.
Ma'am,